Though the previous animation works fine, it is not so effective if we want to animate multiple planes. So I am going to add object-oriented feature to manage multiple plane animation easily. I will create a separate class for plane, create an array list of plane objects, and handle the animation in GameView class. By the end of this lecture, you will be able to understand the benefits of object-oriented programming. So let's get started. Open Android Studio. Right-click on the package and create a new class. Name it Plane. Inside the class, right-click, Generate, Constructor. Pass context as parameter. Cut the bitmap array declaration from gameview.java and paste here in class level. Also, cut and paste the array initialization code in constructor. Change getResources to context.getResources. Next, cut the following declaration from GameView and paste in class level. Int plane x, plane y, velocity, plane frame. Cut and paste the random declaration and instantiation. Next, cut and paste plane x, plane y, and velocity initialization code in plane constructor. For initialization of plane x, we need to access dwidth, which is defined in gameview.java. So, just go to gameview and make dwidth as static. Go to plane.java. Put 1200 and 300 inside next int call for plane x and plane y respectively. For velocity, put 8 plus random.nextint 13. So the value varies between 8 and 20. Here we can access dwidth by writing gameview.dwidth. So just change dwidth to gameview.dwidth. Initialize plane frame to 0. Plane frame equals to 0. Finally, we need to define three methods in plane: public, bitmap, get bitmap. Return plane open close brackets semicolon plane frame. Next, public int get width return plane 0 dot get width. Next, public int get height return plane open close brackets 0 dot get height semicolon. Get rid of the unused codes from game view. We are going to re-implement in a minute. create an array list of planes in GameView.java. We are going to create two plane objects and add to the array list. Java ArrayList class uses a dynamic array for storing the elements. Basically, it can grow and shrink dynamically. Declare in class level. ArrayList. Open close angular brackets. Plane. Planes. Initialize in constructor. Planes equals to new ArrayList. Next, I am going to make two plane objects inside GameView constructor using a for loop and add the objects in ArrayList. In the plane constructor, we should pass the context for int I equals to 0, I less than 2, semicolon, I plus plus, plane equals to new plane. Context planes dot add plane. In onDraw, let's make another for loop and iterate through 0 to the size of ArrayList. For int I equals to 0, I less than planes dot size I plus plus. Inside the for loop, draw the plane bitmap. Canvas dot draw bitmap planes dot get I dot get bitmap comma planes dot get I dot plane x comma planes dot get I dot plane y comma null planes dot get I is used to get an object from the array list with the index value of I. Increase plane frame in the same way. Planes dot get I dot plane frame plus plus. Check the plane frame number. If planes dot get I dot plane frame greater than 14, planes dot get I dot plane frame equals to 0. Decrement plane x by velocity. Planes dot get I dot plane x minus equals to planes dot get I dot velocity. Finally, check whether the plane goes out of the left edge of the screen. If planes dot get I dot plane x less than minus planes dot get I dot get with planes dot get I dot reset position. Let's create reset position method in plane class. Public void reset position. Cut and paste these four lines and put inside this method. Plane x, plane y, velocity and plane frame. Call reset position from constructor. Run the app. Excellent! Now you are able to see two planes flying simultaneously. In fact, in this technique, you can animate any number of planes you want. So, to recap, I have shown you how to create a plane class, create instance variables and methods inside this class to control the animation. We can then reuse this class when required. For example, if we create another plane class, we can simply extend this class. I have also shown you how to create plane objects and add to an array list. Finally, I updated the onDraw method accordingly. I hope you learned few new things in this lecture. Next, I will create another plane class and make the animation even more interesting. See you in the next video.